Hi, this is Captain Steve Tarrant and from Maine Maritime Academy, and in this video we're going to be looking at some definitions associated with damage stability, like permeability, permissible length, compartment standard, things like this. So here's a profile of a merchant vessel. Here you have, the waterline. And up here is called the bulkhead deck. This is the highest deck to which all the main transverse watertight bulkheads would go in. Now, I haven't put those in yet. You'll see them shortly, but it's the highest highest deck to which all the main transverse watertight bulkheads go to. So that's called the bulkhead deck, defined by that green line, which you may or may not be able to see here, right there. So between the waterline and the bulkhead deck, then, is our reserve buoyancy, also known as our freeboard. Okay. Well, it turns out that when vessels are built, you have to have a factor of safety in there. And that factor of safety is expressed as an imaginary line called the margin line. The margin line is defined as a line that is imaginary, that is 3 inches below the bulkhead deck. Okay, so this is not, this PowerPoint is not to scale. This would probably be several feet, but if for the purposes of this video, it's going to represent from here to here, it'll be 3 inches. So that's the margin of safety, called the margin line. And what that means is that this is a quantity of reserve buoyancy that we should be able to maintain under all conditions, okay, as a safety. That would mean that this yellow area of the reserve buoyancy would sort of be the area, this is my own term here, but the area of permissible loss of reserve buoyancy, right, when we're doing our calculations. So, again, that's not to scale. So, this little area here, you see there's a blue dot that just popped up, and you can see that there is a length that is fore and aft of it, and you can see there's this dotted line that goes up either sides. This represents a volume of the ship. And it turns out that this volume of the ship is referred to as the floodable length. So imagine if you choose a point here, you could choose a point here, you could choose a point here. But there will be a volume of the ship fore and after that point that will end up equaling this yellow bit of reserve buoyancy here. Okay, which means that if we flooded the ship between these two boundaries, we would sink the ship up to the margin line, but not beyond it. Okay, this is referred to as the floodable length. So there's a little bit more of a technical definition, but a length around a point that when flooded will submerge the vessel to the margin line, but not beyond. So in this may not be exactly drawn to scale, but in theory then, this blue section would be the same, would represent the same volume of the ship as this yellow area here. Okay. And if we, you see that there, you saw the waterline move up. If we flooded the vessel in this this area here, all right, then the waterline would move up to that margin line, but not beyond it. Okay, and this would be our margin of safety, this red area here. Okay, so this leads us to something called the compartment standard. In this situation, let's say this was a compartment. Well, if we flooded that compartment, we would still be able to survive, and we'd have this extra reserve buoyancy, which would be our safety factor. Well, if let's say we put watertight transverse bulkheads, okay, so here's several more, and they're all, you can see, more or less the same volume here, all right? This would be a one-compartment ship. We could flood any one of these and not sink the ship beyond the margin line, but if we were to fill this and some bit more of the rest of these, the vessel would then be below the margin line, and that would not be very good. If we flooded two of these compartments, we would definitely sink, because we would be up to the bulkhead deck and probably beyond. We'd have no reserve buoyancy left. So this is a one compartment ship, because we could flood one compartment and the vessel would still float with 3 inches of extra reserve buoyancy. But let's say we wanted to make this a two-compartment ship. How could we do that? Well, what we'd have to do is we'd have to divide all these compartments in by two, okay? So to make it a two-compartment ship, we just have to put more transverse watertight bulkheads, okay, in the ship. Now, if we flood these two compartments, it equals this volume, and we'd still have our reserve buoyancy. Okay, from the margin line up to the bulkhead deck. If we flooded these two, same thing. Okay, which, you know, if you imagine if we took some damage right here on the side of the ship, we would flood both of these compartments. Okay, if you took some damage here, right here, you would flood both of these compartments. So it's actually, having a two-compartment ship is probably a pretty good idea. You could have a three-compartment ship, you could have a four-compartment ship. So if we just divided these up again, half again, you can see one, two, three, four, this would be a four-compartment ship. So how do you figure out, these are all terms that you should be familiar with. They're also terms that will be manipulated by the naval architect when they're designing the ship. And so there's this thing called the factor subdivision, all right? And this factor subdivision is the reciprocal of whatever the value is of the compartment standard. So in this case, 1 over the compartment standard. And the number for the factor subdivision will always be 1 or less than 1, okay? So it won't be greater than 1, but it could be some decimal point less than 1. And that takes us to this term called the permissible length, okay? This permissible length is the length that is permissible between main transverse watertight bulkheads, transverse being, you know, athwart ships, okay? Here's this little handy-dandy little formula here for figuring it out. It's the factor of subdivision, which is going to be the reciprocal of the compartment standard, divided by the floodable length. Now, the factor of subdivision we just said was 1 divided by the compartment standard. The floodable length would be defined by your naval architect. So in this problem, we'll just say the floodable length is 30 feet, okay? So a factor subdivision, let's calculate that for a one-compartment ship. Well, it would be the reciprocal of 1, which would be 1 divided by 1, which is 1. For a two-compartment ship, it would be the reciprocal of 2, which is 1 divided by 2, which would be 0.5. For a four-compartment ship, it would be 1 divided by 4, or 0.25. Now, assuming that our floodable length was 30 feet, okay, that this area here from here to here was 30 feet, okay, then for a one-compartment ship, that would be the factor of subdivision, 1 times the permissible length, times the floodable length, 30, which would equal 30 feet. For a two-compartment ship, it would be 0.5 times 30, okay, which would mean 15 feet. That makes sense. And for a four-compartment ship, if the floodable length was 30 feet, it would be 0.25 times 30, which would be 7.5. And here are now a number of those definitions, just with a little bit more, a few more words associated with them. Okay. There's a little Wikipedia, a page down there that's got some nice little pictures and stuff like that.